Hey everyone, it's Ty Beyer with the Dropkeepers, and I'm gonna do a little presentation about the Highest Potential Academy that I just got back from and is in Arizona last week. It was so life-changing. I learned so much. I have a book full of notes about this big from 20 different speakers that talked to us. They talked to us about how to run your business, personalities, how to approach people, just endless list of information that I really can't share with all of you because you really have to be there and to experience it. But I just want to share a few things. I tried to videotape this during our business meeting and it just didn't work because there was so much interaction and people talking and asking questions. It was a phenomenal meeting, but I thought I would just record this at home so those of you who are not in Lubbock and those of you who could not come could just hear my heart and what I shared. So I gave everyone a cute little bottle of Young Living Abundance mixed with Envision, and it's a little rollerball. I got these at convention and I asked everyone to apply it to them and we said a prayer and I told them with the piece of paper that I gave them, and it's a little blue piece of paper and it has clouds so that it's more like you're dreaming and visioning your future. We started with this. I wanted everyone to close your eyes, so go ahead and do this and then pause the video to complete the assignment. So close your eyes. And I just pray, Lord, everyone who is watching this, God, I just pray that they are able to visualize and see the end from the beginning, like setting our minds on things above. God, I just pray that we can speak those things which are not as if they were, because words become flesh and there's power of life and death in the tongue. So I want everyone to think about this statement. Now that I am thriving for 6 months, what's new and different for me is. In a moment, we're going to open our eyes and write down every word that comes to you as quickly as you can. What do you see? What do you smell? What do you taste? What do you feel now that you are thriving? To thrive means to develop vigorously, to prosper, to flourish, to blossom, to bloom, or to advance, to succeed, or to be profitable, to expand. So now that I am thriving for 6 months, what's new and different for me is. Pause the video and go ahead and write down what's new and different. So now that you've done that, you have filled out your little paper and you have envisioned what your future could look like. You can put this up on a vision board. You can put this up. My whole closet is my vision board. And if we just did that and put it on the wall, it's not just going to happen just because we envisioned it. You must take action. And this was so profound and life-changing to me. This right here, there are four steps for us to be able to practically put all the knowledge of network marketing and having a business, how you can practically put it all together, four steps. In the beginning, if you're talking about health, people will start a health program, start working out, start eating better out of fear, usually. They're afraid of the way that they look and how people are going to respond to them or what they're going to think about them. Or maybe they're afraid because they're sick and they are going to be hospitalized if they don't make a change. So they start making a change out of fear. From fear, it moves to reward. They wake up in the morning, they like the way that they look. They look better. They feel better. They have a rewarding test result. And so now they are doing everything to get healthy because of the reward. From reward, they wake up one morning and they love how they feel. They love how they look and they're doing everything to get better because they love it. And from love, one morning someone wakes up, they put on their shoes and socks, and they start out the door to do their workout, but they never once thought about fear. They didn't think about the reward. They didn't think about how much they loved it. It was now nature. It became their nature, and it's a part of them. So fear, reward, love, and nature, and you can put that in anything. So when I started oils, I started out of fear. I didn't want my kids to be sick anymore. I didn't want Isaiah to be hospitalized. I didn't want to go through the trauma that we had been through in the past. So out of fear, I was pouring oils on them, anointing and diffusing, all out of fear. And then there was this reward. Wow, we haven't gotten the flu. We haven't gone to the doctor. I've saved all this money in doctor bills. That's so rewarding. Then I love how our house smells. I love how our children ask for oils. I love how it's in every part of our life where I clean with it, I cook with them, I use them, I make all my own lotions, deodorants, soap, everything. Then one day I'm in, you know, United and someone sneezes next to me and I never once think of anything other than I'm reaching my bag and my purse to give them RC because I know that RC is going to help them with any kind of seasonal allergies. And so I'm just handing it to them. I'm not doing it out of fear. I'm not doing it out of any other reason than it's just my nature. So then someone says, oh, I have a headache. And I pull out my peppermint. I'm like, here you go, try this. It's because it's such a part of me. I don't think twice. I'm not trying to sell them anything out of fear that I don't have enough money and I have to grow my business and I have to sign up people or we're not going to be able to eat. And so I'm telling people about oils out of fear. And then the next stage is reward. Like, oh, that was really nice. I got a paycheck. Someone signed up. That was rewarding. Then you get that paycheck and you start growing your business and you're like, I love this. This is really amazing. When then it goes to, I'm not telling people out of fear. I'm not telling people because I want a reward or because I love it so much. I'm telling people because it's my nature and it's very natural. It was so profound to me when I heard this presentation. I was just like, oh my goodness, this is for me. This is a practical way that I can approach my business. So on the back of your paper, now that we're going to do an action, because you can't just visualize and want things to poof and just appear. So now on the back of the side, write some practical steps you can do every day, income producing activities you can do every day that is going to bring income into your business. These might be things that scare you, things that you don't want to do, but things you know you need to do. Contacting people, calling people, follow up with people, schedule classes, schedule one-on-ones. Those are income producing activity. So write that on the back, five things that you are committing to do every day of your work day. Because if we go to an 8 to 5, it's work. So why wouldn't we have to work our network marketing business to make money? So go ahead and pause it and write down your five things. So now that you've done that, you have to, what this next presenter told us was write everything you have to do in a whole day. Write your whole list and then highlight the things that make you really scared, the things you want to avoid, the things that you don't like doing. Highlight all of those and do those first and commit to doing it. And at first, you're going to be doing it out of fear. And then it's going to be rewarding because you're crossing it off. Then you love doing it because it's amazing that you feel accomplished. You're getting things done. And it's such an amazing feeling that it becomes your nature. You would work if you went to an 8 to 5. You're going to work if you're a network marketer and you want to be successful. No one's just successful because of the vision board. You have to take actions and you have to be consistent. Does that mean when I go to New Mexico that I just say, see everyone? No, I posted the whole time we were in New Mexico. I shared how I was using the oils in New Mexico. A loved one was in the hospital, so I posted scriptures about essential oils. I don't just back out. I wouldn't back out of another job. So that was so amazing. Be consistent and you will get paid. It was so wonderful. You want to do the oils until it becomes such nature to you that when you approach someone with the oils or with the business, they don't feel like, oh, she's trying to sell something to me. Oh, run from her. Don't talk to her. They're going to be like, oh, this really helped her. This is a part of her. And she genuinely cares about me. I'm going to try this product. It's a totally different approach. It's wonderful. Now, this next thing, I'm going to tell you all the statements. They're just one sentence statements that stood out to me. And then I'm under this video, I'm going to write them all. So just listen to them and then you can copy them and put them in your notes. This will really help you. So these are some tips. Number one, you cannot talk to a giver like you would talk to a type A personality. So every single person in your group has a different personality. You can go and take any kind of personality test on the internet. There's a lot of them that are for free, but God made each individual different. So if you have a giver in your group, you cannot talk to them like a go-getter type A hardcore personality because that's gonna turn them away. Nor could you talk to a type A personality like you would a tender giver. That's going to totally turn that person away. So you need to know who you're talking to, know your audience, and to talk to each person according to how God made them. So you need to know your team, get to know them, and then know how to relate to each personality. That's so profound. So a rotating kit. every business builder should invest in a rotating kit. What is a rotating kit? It is a kit that you buy, and when you have it there, it's always with you. So when your new member signs up, you give them that rotating kit. And then when you put their information on the computer, it says ship to, and it can be a different ship to address. You ship that kit back to the one that they just bought. So it's a rotating kit that just keeps coming in and out. I like to call in each order. Or if someone's sitting with me, I'll do it right there on the computer. And it's so easy because people want their product immediately. And if they can get it in their hands immediately, then you can show them immediately how to use it. So one of the ladies there said that she puts each of the kits in a nice bag, a pretty bag that's beautiful, and puts a little free book. I highly recommend that if you sign someone up, you give them a desk reference. It costs $11 if you buy them in bulk. That's an investment, because if somebody gets a kit, they're not going to know how to use it unless they have the tools. So I highly recommend that you go to Life Science and buy some in bulk so that you can give them to your members so that they know how to use them. The person who does the most prospecting, talking to people, they're the ones who make the most money. So if you want to talk to people, if you want to sign people up, if you want your business to grow, you have to get yourself out there. Talk to people everywhere you go. Give your business cards out to everyone that you meet. And that's how you're going to meet new contacts. You can't just be successful not talking to anyone. You have to get out of your comfort zone. The more you practice, the easier it will become. Another amazing little idea was to make the people your members, either you want to give it to them immediately when they buy the kit, or the members who aren't really using their kit. That was someone came up with this idea and I thought it was brilliant. You just make this little $5 care package with a little glass jar of Epsom salt with no oil, and you give it to them and you say, put some oil, whatever oil you like the best, put it in there and enjoy it in your bath. Or give them an empty spray bottle with a little witch hazel in it and say, make your own room spray. Give them 10 little vegetable capsules and say, here, this will get you started. Here's some vegetable capsules that you can take your oils. And then use your old essential oil bottles, take the outside off and fill it up with carrier oil. And then, because people always ask, what carrier oil? Where do I get carrier oil? What is carrier oil? Well, here you go. You already have one. Here's a little bottle. That's nothing. It costs maybe 10 cents for you to do. So it's an investment in your group. Maybe they're not buying anything. So you make them a little care package of, this is how you use the oils. Let's sit down together. Or it's an incentive for getting them to sign up. Whatever you feel like would help your business, that makes people understand how to use their oils in 5 different ways. And it's very helpful and effective. I'm going to start doing that. People buy you, they don't buy the product. So they are watching you. What are you doing? What are you posting on Facebook? What does your profile look like? Are you being negative? Are you saying things against other people? Are you posting inappropriate things? And then the next post is about essential oils or a business meeting. People want to follow people that they respect and look up to. So you have to always be working on personal development, whether you're listening to recordings or reading books. Personal development is huge. Like, I feel like I've grown so much just going to Arizona and learning all these invaluable tips that I can now share with other people. I'm becoming a stronger leader. I'm not the same person I was 2 years ago when I started. I have learned so much. You have to continually reinvent yourself, pour into yourself, and grow. We are doing something for our customers. We're not doing something to. We are helping them. So think of it, I'm not doing something for, but I'm doing it. I am doing something for my customers. I'm not doing something to them. Doing something to them is negative, but doing something for them is positive. And then you feel more confidence to help people. So when someone says no, try saying, I think that might be a mistake. And let me tell you why. These oils have changed my life. How much does it cost for you to go to the doctor each time? How much are the medications that you're using? How often are you sick? How much work are you missing? How many sick days are your kids experiencing? Is this possibly might be worth your time? Can you reconsider? So I'm just going to talk to them about it, because I truly believe it's part of my nature that it's going to change people's lives. And try saying something like, if somebody says, I just want to buy one lavender, try saying, can I make a recommendation? May I recommend that you just go ahead and invest in your family and yourself and get your premium starter kit, because then you can do it all online. It's all there for you. You get the 24% off discount. It's a phenomenal deal. Can I recommend that for you? You must be 10 to 15 times bolder in this business. You have to believe that the product is life-changing, and you have to believe in yourself enough that people want to hear from you. People are ready for you, and they accept you before you even walk in the door. Another thing you can say to people who are really good friends or family, say, as a personal favor to me, would you please let me use your kitchen table to teach a class? Just invite a few friends, two or three friends, and just let me practice with them as a personal favor. That is opening up. Maybe your friend's not interested at all, but maybe her friends are, and that will open up a whole new universe for you to meet a different group of people you never would have before. You have to think so much further and bigger than the circle that are around you. Celebrate every small victory. When you sign up someone, like, really celebrate. Be like, this is fantastic. Be proud of yourself. Reward yourself. Don't immediately say, okay, I need to sign someone else up, because that's going back to fear. That's not being loving and being in your nature. So your nature is one person is so important. You don't know what that one person's going to do, or how their life is going to be forever, eternally changed. So you are making a difference in one person's life. Lighten up and have fun. I just circled that, put a smiley face, put little stars around it, because this should be fun. Like, this is a fun job. So if we have more fun, then it won't be all stressed out. I love that one of the speakers, her husband owns several different Burger Kings, and she talked about if somebody came in and she said, would you like fries and a drink with that? And they said no, she wouldn't run and go need therapy and counseling because someone told her no. You just say next and go to the next customer. So you just release them. Just let it go. And there's other people. And just pray that God will give people a revelation of his healing oils, and it'll be life-changing for them. So don't get all sad when someone says no. It's usually just not yet. And I have a list of my not yets. It's a whole list of miracle names that I wrote down. And it's a list full of names of people, front and back, that are my miracle list of people that I've been talking to. Maybe they're just not ready. And every time that they sign up, I put a little smiley face or a little heart by it, because I'm so excited. So I have an ongoing list of people that I've already talked to, but they haven't signed up. And then a whole list of people that I have not talked to yet, but that I will talk to. And then once I've talked to them, they'll go on my miracle list, or they'll become one of my members. So you just always have to think about who needs this, whose lives will be changed, and who is ready to hear it. Instead of saying, can I have your information, or will you give me your information? I want your information. That kind of sounds like, ooh, why you want my information? Instead, say, by the way, my name's Ty Beyer. Let's trade information. Here's my information. What's yours? Then it doesn't feel so aggressive and scary for people. This was so good. Stay and be consistent and you will succeed. There was one lady at the convention, at the conference, and I talked to her for a little while. She was so sweet and kind. I said, how long have you been doing Young Living? She said 10 years, and she just became a diamond. That's phenomenal. For doing a business for 10 years and to become a diamond, that's a substantial income. But she was consistent. You know she had heartaches. You know it was difficult to build, and it took her 10 years. Some people do it in 2 years, but she just didn't give up. And that's such a victory. It says that 98% of network marketers give up in their first year. It's because people think it's easy. Like, you just put a few posts on Facebook and then you're going to be rich. No, it's work. For a year and a half, I didn't make a penny because I poured every penny back into my business. I have invested. I have educated myself. I've been at every convention since I've started. I've bought all the books. I've done the boot camp. I've went to 3 different healing oils of the Bible and raindrop training. Like, I have trained myself. I have invested in myself. I've invested in every member. I'm fully there for them. So it's work. I mean, it's work. If you want to get paid, you have to work. But a lot of people think that you don't. You can't just dream it and think it's going to happen. You have to take steps to becoming successful, or you won't become successful and you'll be one of the 98%. And when we hear the success stories, we're like, oh, she was a diamond in 2 years and it's not going to happen to me. Well, whoever made it to diamond in 2 years worked her tail off and made great sacrifices to get there. So it doesn't just happen overnight. We must work on ourselves and we must work the business consistently, no matter what. Your mind will do what you tell it to do. You need to be positive. Like, criticism should be unfamiliar to you. You should never criticize, but we should always praise. That should become so familiar to us that we praise, and we never give an opportunity for us to be offended. Because in this business, you're working with people, there will be times your heart will absolutely fall out of your chest. It hurts terribly. But you know what? You have to give grace and forgiveness and love and mercy all the time. You cannot be let any kind of offense come into your heart, because that will hinder your business. You must release, and you must give grace fully all the time, 100%. I don't have my little medal right now, but one of the last things that I want to say is, don't wait for me as one of the leaders to host the class, to do the different incentives, to lead. You are a leader. If you have this vision, it must be yours. When I started, I had to fully learn myself and lead a new army, because I had no idea what I was doing, and I made a lot of mistakes. I made so many mistakes that now I can help others not make the same mistakes. But had I not just started from ground one and said, this is what I'm doing, this is my passion, and I'm going to learn as I go, you must be the leader of your own path. You have to take your own incentive and to find something deep inside of you, your passion, your vision for your growth, and you have to do it. I will be there for you 100%. I'm going to lead you, and I'm going to help you, and I will help others on your team. But if you want it to be yours and you want to go to the next level, you must take full ownership. You must marry the thought. It's not something like, oh, no one signed up this month and I've been rejected too many times, so I'm just going to quit. No. If you've made a commitment, this is something you're going to do. You're going to do it no matter what. And if you stay consistent, 100%, you will be successful. My husband made me this amazing little medal out of foil with my kids when I was trying to get silver, and I missed it over and over again, but I didn't give up. It was discouraging because I really wanted to go to Silver Retreat. Young Living sends you for free, and I wanted that so bad, and I didn't make it, but I didn't give up. On my little medal, I put try again, and I kept trying until I made it, and I will keep trying until I make gold. And my goal is to make gold by May 2017. So the May that's coming up, I want to be gold, a solid gold, not just like a one-time gold. I want a solid foundation and make gold. And I want to go to Gold Retreat next year. And I fully believe that I will, because I'm going to work for it. Every day, I'm going to do the things that make me feel very uncomfortable until it becomes my nature. I'm going to do it day after day, and I'm going to pour out unconditional love. And that is our theme for the Dropkeepers, duplicate love. And everything that I do, I'm going to duplicate love. And when I become gold, I'm going to be able to give and help so many people. I'm not stopping at gold. I will go all the way. I don't know how long it will take, but I will make it there. And I believe that I'll bring an army with me. And I pray that it's you. Thank you for your time. God bless you.